I'm working on a brand new impression. You know, I like my impressions. It's this. It's hello, hello. Must be someone. Hello, I'm up to them and the Buzzcocks. Phil's first guest is one third of chart topping garage trio Mystique. It's Sue Elise.
You're dangerous. Just get it off. So
at the age of 11, Sue Elise went on stage in front of Prince Charles to perform Beauty and the Beast, a musical he particularly enjoys because it reminds him of his wife and his girlfriend. His second guest used to be an Irish group Chill, but now presents Top of the Pops and Techno Games, Liz Bonin. Liz recently left Channel 4 breakfast show Rise, saying she was sick of having to set her alarm for 5 o'clock every morning, unlike the viewers who set their alarm for 1 minute past nine. Liz and Sue Elise, Phil C, ladies and gentlemen. Phil's first guest tonight is a chart-topping remixer and producer all the way from Spain. It's DJ Sammy. DJ Sammy's worked with Mariah Carey and Bryan Adams, and his payment for tonight's show is a big bucket of Tippex so he can get to work remixing his CV. Phil's second guest is an American stand-up and sitcom star, Tom Rhodes. Nowadays, Tom hosts his own chat show on Dutch television. Of course, being Dutch TV, it's not just books and videos that get plugged. There's also clips of transvestite nuns and Alsatians being plugged. Tom and Sammy, Bill's team, ladies and gentlemen. You think that's all we've got, don't you? You think that's all we've got. You think, oh, he's got loads of panellists. But no, we've got games as well. And we're starting the show with, guess who? Phil, Sue, Elise and Liz. Here are two ballad belters for you. But which one recently had their half-eaten sandwich auctioned off by a radio station?
Break my heart.
Was it Gerbil George, Mariah, One from Over the Cuckoo's Nest, Carey? Or was it split crotch friendly Tom Makeup by Sunny Delight Jones?
Well, she knows me through and through, and she knows just what to do and how. Please, she's a lady. Whoa, 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 she's a lady.
Man, look at Tom's powers of observation there. People in the audience go, what sex is that woman next to you?
She's a lady. Oh.
One of those two recently had a sandwich auctioned off.
No.
But it's just going to go mouldy, isn't it?
Yeah, I didn't buy it. It's not a show I just show off about stuff I've got. One of them sold a sandwich.
And I've got it.
Let's have a look. Mariah, for some reason, at the beginning of... is powdering her bosoms.
Looks like she's searching for fingerprints or something. Powdering for fingerprints.
If she's powdering there, I hate to think where she's putting the lipstick.
We don't think they're real.
Well, the rumour is that she's had a boob job, but who on earth would get a boob job and get them made
separately
that way,
like that,
as opposed to...
You'd want them to sit right in the middle.
They sit that way.
No, she likes reading. Very close.
She's short-sighted as well. Now, you see, back in the day, they could make them big, but they couldn't, you know, make them
together.
Sat together.
That's
didn't have the technology.
How long ago did she have this boob job, back in the day?
Back in the day.
The very early in the Hans Press. You see, now they do the silicone with the actual one, but she's got beanie breasts. Like the bean bag, they're collectible.
People can get valves, can't they, for like actual boob jobs? Oh. Valves in your skin, and you put water in it.
Really?
You can top them up when you like.
Yeah, no, seriously.
You can keep.
If you've got a colostomy as well, you can open one valve, enlarge your breasts. You can go to the toilet and look sexier at the same time. It's never happened before.
You look great.
I've been for a piss.
For some reason, in the cinema, her boyfriend goes to kiss her. She proffers the chihuahua. But, of course, he's in a win-win situation there, because the next day he can break to his mates, I kiss Mariah Carey's chihuahua. And his mates probably go, oh, lucky you.
Yeah.
Then let's look at Tom Jones here. There's these two women. That's the man, officer.
We love the belt.
That's not a belt. That's actually a fanny magnet suppressor. To stop his powerful fanny magnet.
What I'm really clocking is the medallion on the hairy chest.
Right.
Could that cross be any bigger?
Bling, bling.
That is, but I would imagine in the circles you move in, that's a tiny little cross. I've seen some of the solid crew, they had a life-size crucifix. He's got that weird thing now, isn't he, where he goes... Like every now and again, he'll
be
singing.
Twitch.
Why? he does that in every song. It's really odd.
Sex bomb. Keep it together, Tom. Go.
Then we see what side he dresses there. Look, what has he got down there?
It's not even the right shape, though, is it? I mean, even if it's big, it's
not the right shape
round
for
you know.
Oh, Jesus!
It's like
yes.
a sock, doesn't it? That's like.
Wow! I think that's low tonsils.
Right. But he had his nose reduced back in the. Well, they said he had his nose reduced back in the 60s when he was meant to be having tonsillitis or whatever,
yes.
and he probably sucked the extra bit down there.
His dancers in the back there are all. They look like
very curvaceous, aren't they?
Polish gymnast.
I like big butts and I can't lie.
It's not Yo Boss Cox raps.
Flip mold.
The sandwich. I'm thinking Mariah.
I can't imagine Tom. I'm not leaving that. That's a perfectly good half a sandwich.
We're going to say Mariah.
Yes,
you're gonna
we are.
You're going to say Mariah?
Mm. You're right, it was Mariah Carey. Last year, a half-eaten turkey sandwich was auctioned for $571 by a radio station, along with the plastic knife that she'd used. Obviously, she's not allowed to have real knives. or her own shoelaces. Sterling, she's getting better. Now she's only half a sandwich short of a picnic. While on holiday in Aspen, Mariah Carey offered guests $100 each to get out of the hotel's jacuzzi so she could enjoy it alone with her husband. They were so eager to accept that they barely had time to finish their piss before wishing the couple well. Bell, Sammy and Tom, two visions of feminine beauty for you. Which one is the president of the Basking Shark Society?
He took my heart, it wasn't his. You know it wasn't his.
Is it spandex-thighed, sweat-stained video vixen Olivia Newton-John? Or is it trout-lipped, rock twiglet, Aerosmith Steven Tyler? One of those is desperate to preserve the world's second-largest fish.
I bought a sandwich out of loot once.
Really? Yeah. It wasn't a basking shark sandwich, was it?
That would be... No. It was in loot, yeah. Cheese and pickle, £5, no time wasters.
Unwanted lunch present.
Well, Olivia Newton-John, can we see it again? It's just random images. It just looks like somebody's taped over something. You know what I mean? It's not like... you know what I mean? It's,
actually,
oh, what we got? It's the song's called Landslide. It's like, oh, no, we can't afford a landslide. No, you can have two blokes with a sword. There's a top, there's something else. There's candles. I mean, you know, we got 20 quid. It does look like a bit of a porn shoot, though, to me. It's
just, what, musketeer porn?
Yeah. It's turned out and said, I've come to repair the candlesticks.
Musketeer porn would be a gangbang, wouldn't it? Because it would all be all for one and one for all, sure.
Got a vaguely Spanish feel to this. You know, is this sort of thing you get up for?
Vaguely. Do people still sword fight in Spain all the time?
Yeah, I've seen it. Going around with the boat, they were doing some stuff like this, but the positions are very strange. They're not Spanish positions.
Oh, right.
Actually, yeah.
What? Show me a Spanish position. Not. Ah. So you're sword fighting a midget? How long is their reach, little people, how long is their reach going to be? And they, you probably just give them a little knitting needle, didn't you, and you muck about with them. I like the fact that because Sammy's Spanish, he's our expert on sword fighting.
Well, it's taught from school, isn't it? It's just sword, you know, math, double maths, fencing. Then they bring a bull in for games. Oh, I hate games.
Last day of time, you'll have to throw a donkey off a tower.
There's a dog in here as well. I don't understand what...
This is clearly animal cruelty that this dog has to listen to this song.
He's actually silently going...
The dog is there saying, nobody's leaving the place.
Is he actually saying that?
Talk to the animals. I don't know this song. Is it? Does he actually say it, or is he thinking it?
Yeah, he says it.
I'd be great if he was a rapping dog. Flip mode, it would be great, wouldn't it?
He's saying, listen, guys, it's a low-budget video. Please do your best. You know what I mean?
Is he the director?
OK, first positions.
Doggy style.
Doggy style. Can somebody take the drool away from my mouth? All right, see the rockers then.
And actually, this beautiful video, 70s video.
ZZ Top's wedding video.
Yeah. This takes me back.
It would be a great wedding gift for this couple as a beard trimmer.
Does anyone know of any legal impediment? Speak now. It's a bloke! She's marrying a bloke!
It's all right when a woman marries a bloke, Bill.
Is that a woman?
It's not like a troll marrying a goat. That was as poor as your barber.
I mean, listen, guys, they really look quite happy. Look at that, it's beautiful.
Yeah.
It looks happy, beautiful couple. Look at that, man.
Did we book him?
He's delightful. I want one.
Flip mall.
I may have misheard, but did you say flip mole?
Yes.
I think you did.
It's a Spanish tradition, they flip a mole.
It's weird, there's all that fuss about bullfighting, but the mole flipping, they don't mind, do they? Flip mole! It'd be lovely if Busta Rhymes kept saying flip mole. Maybe I misheard him all these years.
Let me see the one with the sax lady. Sax lady. There's no joke here, we just wanted to look at her ass. So,
Yo, what's up?
I've never got that rat
for
thing.
For real.
See, that is a rat thing. You take the fingers away, it's like George.
Let's talk about basking sharks.
I actually know this. The basking shark is the only, one of the two vegetarian sharks, along with the whale shark. That's what I know. I think it's Olivia Newton-John.
Really?
Flip a mole.
Yes.
Flip mole.
Flip mole.
That's it, yeah. Flip a mole, I don't mind. You say whatever you want, you're delightful. I've never had a pet as a kid. Yeah, you're quite right, of course. It is Olivia Newton-John. She's president of the Basking Shark Society, which aims to prevent the fish being hunted to extinction and ending up as shark fin soup. When Olivia Newton-John appeared on the Eurovision Song Contest, her costume was voted for by the public. I wish we could still do that. I'd vote for Ronan Keating in a chalk outline. Next up is the intros round. Phil and Sue Elise, who are yours to do towards Liz?
Is the singing bit?
Well, not really.
No. Go on, girl. You can do this.
2, 3, 4.
It could be the intro to any dance track.
Yeah, no, it could, couldn't it?
It sounds really familiar, but like.
It does sound like every. If you've ever been to Ibiza or you live anywhere near a council estate and cars pass.
What's the.
Yeah. Oh. Yeah.
I do know it.
I know
it's like on the tip of my tongue, and I know I know it. But
how do you know she knows it?
I know
she
knows it.
She said she knows it.
Because I know she knows it. Trust me.
And I know she knows that she knows it.
See, I don't know that you know. I know that he knows that you know that she knows it, but I don't know that you know that she knows it.
No, but I know she doesn't know. I know that she knows it. I know.
All right, she knows. She knows what you think you know, but you don't.
I do.
What is it then?
I don't know. Ah.
Do you know what it is, Sammy?
Roll out of the barrel.
I'm going to put down fresh paper for him tonight. He's fantastic. I am. I'm putting some little toys for him to play with. That, it